ladies and gentlemen, we are live from the Tyson Event Center in Sioux City, Iowa. This is Sioux City Bandits football in the National Arena League for the opening week of the 2024 season. Good evening, everybody. I am Braden Butler. Thank you for joining me this evening on the National Arena League YouTube page for the week one action from the NAL between the Sioux City Bandits and the Oklahoma Flying Aces. We're announcing your Sioux City Bandits roster right now, so let's run through it with them as they are introduced to the home crowd faithful inside the Tyson Event Center. First off, number zero, Agent Zero, the 6-foot defensive back out of Oklahoma State, Justin Gilbert. Justin Gilbert, his path to this to the NAL is well publicized. Former first round pick by the Cleveland Browns back in 2014. He's got a very talented duo partner in that secondary, and that's this man right here, number one, the 6'1 defensive back from Morningside College, Xavier Spann. Agent Zero and X-Man, Professor X, whatever you want to call him, out there in the defensive secondary. Next man out, they call him the franchise. Number two, 5'8" tall out of Wayne State College, the wide receiver, Fred Bruno, a staple of this Bandits organization. 4 years. Another wide receiver of the Sioux City Bandits teams, one of two players who carry a lot of height with them in this wide receiver room, and this is Sammy Epps, 6'4", 215 pounds out of Ole Miss. Another great defensive back for this Sioux City team. Got an interception last week in the preseason game. It's Carlton Watkins, the 5'10 D-back out of Tiffin University. Welcome back to quite possibly the most legendary quarterback in the Bandits history, Scott Jensen. Going for career touchdown pass number 200 tonight. He will get the start. See how long it takes him if he's able to get that 200th touchdown pass. Next man out is number 10, the linebacker, Braden Mintz. And I use the term linebacker loosely. He does everything for this team. He kicked last year. He played wide receiver. He's won the ball. I wouldn't be surprised if he drives the bus to away games. He does it all. He's the Swiss Army knife for this Sioux City Bandits team. Next man out, number 12, the defensive lineman, Ossie Tapua, 6'3", 235 out of Briarcliff University. Next man out, number 13, quarterback out of York University. It's Tyler Launstein, 6'2", 215. Went 5-for-8 with 2 touchdowns in the Bandits preseason game last week. Next up is the defensive back, 6'5", a tall man in that defensive backfield. Number 16, Juan Moore out of Minnesota West Community College. Here's the bell cow for this Bandits running attack. Number 20, the running back, 5'8" tall out of Briarcliff University, Drew Prohaska. The Bandits will run jet sweeps out of with run, wide receivers as well, but that is the running back, the lone running back listed on the roster, Drew Prohaska. Next up, Sherman Gilbert, the younger brother of Justin Gilbert out of Southeastern Oklahoma State University. He's a rookie in the NAL this season, 5'11", 170-pound defensive back. Next up, number 26, the defensive lineman. They call him the long arm of the law out of Morningside College. 6 feet, 260 pounds. It's Devin Groenhagen. Another defensive back for this Bandits team out of Tusculum University. It's Aaron Roundtree. He stands 6'1" tall, 210 pounds. Carries some arena experience with him into this season. Former Northern Iowa Panther out next, number 29, the wide receiver, 6'2", 200 pounds. Another rookie for this Bandits team as well. It's Leslie Owusu. Got a local guy here at the kicker position for Sioux City. Number 30, the 6'2", 215-pound Jared Amundson. He's a rookie at this level as well. Getting some of your big boys in the trenches. Number 55, the offensive lineman, Omar Roberts, 6'4", 310 out of Carthage College. Number waiting on the next man out of the tunnel here for the Sioux City Bandits. Another offensive lineman, 6'2", 350 pounds. Goes by DJ. It's DeJarlis Reese wearing the number 73 for the Bandits. They don't build many like this guy. 6 feet, 6 inches tall, 330 pounds. Number 78, the offensive lineman, Rashad Mungrow. They don't build a lot like him, but the Bandits got another one coming out shortly. Here first is David Vargas, number 90, the 6'2", 320-pound defensive lineman out of the University of Sioux Falls. Here's the other man they build. 6 feet, 6 inches tall, 5 pounds less at 325. Number 96, it's Steven Fluker. Big man in the trenches. Going to be a part of that road grader offensive line. The Bandits want to establish a passing game and a running game. That offensive line is going to be crucial in both of those facets. Your defensive coordinator today is Marlon Loban. Your offensive coordinator is also your starting quarterback for the day, Scott Jensen, as he goes for career touchdown pass number 200. And a big one, the head coach, Irv Strobeen. Huge milestone potentially for him. He is going for career win number 100. Huge game potentially for head coach Strobeen. Since the background into this one, we've met the Sioux City Bandits. It's their first year in the National Arena League. They defended the Minneapolis Warriors 49-14 in their preseason game last week. Talked about the day for potential history for the Bandits. Strobeen going for his 100th career win as head coach. Quarterback and offensive coordinator Scott Jensen looking for his 200th career touchdown pass. And also today is the Iowa Corn Agriculture Appreciation Game. So big thank you to Iowa Corn for what they've helped us do here outside the Tyson Event Center, teaching kids and everybody about agriculture in the state of Iowa. As for Oklahoma, it's their first year in the National Arena League after being dormant since the 2019 season. And we'll get more into them when we come back from our national anthem here. Sioux City Bandits football taking on the Oklahoma Flying Aces coming up shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, please take off your hats tonight and rise for the singing of tonight's national anthem by Miss Elizabeth Ross.
Welcome back in here. National Arena League football on the way between the Sioux City Bandits and the Oklahoma Flying Aces. We were talking about the Flying Aces a little bit before we went off for the national anthem performed by Miss Elizabeth Ross here inside the Tyson Event Center in Sioux City. This is their first year in the National Arena League for the Flying Aces. They've been dormant since they wrapped up the 2019 season in the CIF. Went 2-10 in that final season and are looking to establish themselves on the arena football landscape once again. It's their first game of the year with no preseason opponent last week. Coming in on short notice, too, for Oklahoma. Due to scheduling changes that need to be made within the National Arena League, training camp for the Flying Aces began earlier this week. So it's a quick turnaround for their first game of the season. Take a look at their active roster this evening. It'll be number 0, Arnell Anderson, the defensive back out of Illinois State. Number 1, the wide receiver out of Texas Arlington, Zuri Davis. Number 3, the defensive back out of Baylor, Keontae Griffin. Number 4, another defensive back, this one out of Marshall, it's Lakeith Murray. Number 5, running back out of Thomas Moore, Manalo Caldwell. Number 6, a wide receiver out of Tulsa, Thomas Bingham. And number 7, another receiver, William Langford out of the University of Pikeville. Another defensive back here, number 8, LeBaron Mallory. Number 11, the quarterback this evening, was signed in to play wide receiver, but due to some players dropping out during camp, Torrance Carr-Young will be moving to the quarterback position today. He'll be wearing the number 11. Kicker for this team today will be number 13, Brandon Stewart out of Kent State. Bandits fans will know him. He played for the Bandits at the end of last season down the stretch. So a bit of a homecoming or welcome back to Sioux City for him as he signed on with the Flying Aces for today. Number 14, the wide receiver out of the South Dakota School of Mines, Rashad Ridley. Number 17, defensive back out of Dodge City Community College. Keep this name in mind. He has almost 30 interceptions over his last two professional indoor seasons as Draco Statham. That's going to be someone you need to keep an eye on all night long. You, me, as well as the quarterback. Whoever's out there for the Bandits, whether it's Launstein, whether it's Jensen, you got to keep an eye on Statham. Also for Oklahoma will be number 18, the defensive lineman out of Arkansas Baptist College, Austin Jones. Number 44, defensive lineman out of North Carolina A&T, Trey Smalls. Offensive lineman out of South Alabama, Rob Powell, was number 58. Ben Hughes, number 71, the defensive lineman out of Oklahoma State. Number 75, Gene Tapia, the offensive lineman out of Franklin Pierce University. 79, Rufus Quinn, the O-lineman out of Arkansas Tech. And rounding out today's active roster for the Oklahoma Flying Aces, number 88, Karan Bolden, the defensive lineman out of Glendale College. Let's take a look at a couple of your key players for the Bandits in this one. Obviously, you're going to have to go quarterback Scott Jensen going for his touchdown pass, number 200 in his career. They're honoring legends all season out of the Bandits, and one of the best to ever suit up in Sioux City looks to surpass a historic milestone. On the defensive side, it's going to be one more. Two picks, including a pick six last week in the preseason game against Minneapolis. He's a 6'5" defensive back who impressed the Bandits in an open tryout earlier this year and solidified his standing with a great showing last week. Looking to see if he can carry that momentum into the league season. Key players on the Oklahoma side of things, you're going to have to go Torrance Carr-Young stepping in at quarterback this game. We'll see what he does under center or out of the shotgun, whatever offense they like to run in Oklahoma. We'll see how the converted wide receiver to quarterback, who has done it in the past in the indoor football level, that's not what he was brought in for. So we'll see how he can do today at the quarterback position. And defensively, it's going to be Draco Statham. You don't get that many interceptions over 2 years and not have a big red X next to your name in the scouting report. He's going to be another key player for Oklahoma today. Just had the coin toss down on the field. I see Devin Groenhagen, Scott Jensen, Fred Bruno, and Drew Prohaska were out there for the Bandits. Statham, Griffin, and Ridley were three players out there for Oklahoma. This should be a good one here. Opening game of the 2024 National Arena League season. Great showing last week for the Bandits in their preseason game. That was a 49-14 win over the Minneapolis Warriors. Now, we talked about Scott Jensen coming in, looking for career touchdown pass number 200, but it's put into perspective his numbers for the Bandits in his career. He has completed just under 58% of his passes at 703 completions to 1,226 attempts, has 9,139 passing yards, 13 yards per completion, 199 touchdowns to 45 interceptions in his career. He's also a dual threat, 342 carries for 1,410 yards, 4.1 yards per carry, and 34 rushing touchdowns from the quarterback position. Should be a fun one today. A little miscommunication there for the Bandits out of the gates. Braden Mintz and Aussie Tapua went to one end of the field for the kickoff. The rest of the kick coverage team went to the other. Now we got it sorted out. Sioux City Bandits football coming your way here on the National Arena League YouTube page. Back deep to return, Rashad Ridley. He's a dangerous return man in the indoor football game, so that's someone got to keep an eye on, see if Mainz tries to kick it away from him, if they go right after him. We'll see the special team strategy here as we get rolling for Sioux City Bandits football. Mainz has it teed up, marches out his steps, puts a boot through it, end over end, spiraling towards the boards. That is going to go out of play into the stands. They do keep it away from Ridley. Looks like it crossed over the boards in the end zone. Like I say, it went out before going into the end zone, so ball will be placed at the 20-yard line. First and 10 from their own 20. For the Oklahoma Flying Aces, good field position for them to start just near the halfway line. See the starters down there for the Bandits defense. Ossie Tapu on the defensive line, as well as David Vargas and Devin Groenhagen. Your corners, Xavier Spann and Justin Gilbert. Braden Mice, the linebacker, over the top. Looks like Carlton Watkins and Juan Moore. Carlton Watkins also got an interception last week, as did Xavier Spann. Five turnovers forced, four picks, one fumble by the Bandits defense last week against Minneapolis. We'll see what Oklahoma has for them. It's our first taste of Flying Aces football in almost 5 years. New coat of paint, new league, a lot of new things. We'll see what Torrance Carr-Young has. Shotgun formation. Quarterback takes the snap, rolls out to his right. Forced a step up in the pocket. Groenhagen gets there, as well as Ossie Tapua, and that's going to be a sack for the Sioux City Bandits. Devin Groenhagen, the long arm of the law, making his statement here early on. Gets a sack on the first play of the game. Tapua was in there as well. It's going to bring up second and 11. This defensive line for the Bandits, very new look compared to last season. Claude Davis, Dejon Emery, they have moved on. Different teams, they are out of the Sioux City Bandits organization for the time being. I know the door is always open for them to come back if they want to. But Tapua, Groenhagen, and Vargas got to fill those holes. Big sack there to start. Carr-Young in the shotgun. They're going to hand this one off to Caldwell. Off the left side, gets through the initial set of tacklers. He's eventually brought down by Juan Moore. Flag is going to fly. We got some laundry on the field. Penalty flags are brought to you by Flans Electronics. See who it's on here. Carlton Watkins was saying it was against an Oklahoma player. They're going to get a block in the back on William Langford, the wide receiver out of the University of Pikeville. Going to march him back after a solid opening run for Manalo Caldwell as well. Second and 15 now as we go here. Chain Gang was having a little trouble getting the sticks set up, so now we take a little break, let them get out of the way. Now the clock will start rolling again. The officials put more time on the board for Oklahoma, so takes the snap, does Carr-Young, fakes the handoff. He's going to try to go off the left side. He's going to meet Braden Mainz in the gap, and Mainz is going to bring him down. Big play there for Braden Mainz, getting the first tackle of the game, but a gain of about 3-4. Torrance Carr-Young brings up third and 12. Third and 12 here in Sioux City. Big defensive opportunity here for the Bandits. Carr-Young is going to go empty set. Four wide receivers on the field. Sends one in motion. Takes the snap, looking right now, looks back up the middle, and there's going to be a blitzing Braden Mainz in his face, brings him down. A lot of emotion there from Mainz up the middle on the linebacker blitz. Fourth and very long now for Oklahoma. Big play there, a pair of sacks on this opening drive for this Sioux City Bandits defense. Going to bring in Brandon Stewart to try to boot this one. Looks like Zuri Davis to hold. Stewart, left-footed kicker. The hold's going to be put down about his own 5-yard line. A couple changes being made here for Oklahoma. Looks like a delay of game is going to be called. They were miscommunication on who was supposed to get in and snap the ball. It's going to back them up 5 more yards. So basically kicking this one from their own goal line now will be Oklahoma. In the shadow of his own uprights, near the new rebound nets here in the National Arena League this season. Snap is good, hold is down, Stewart boots it, and spiraling towards the stands, and that's going to be a souvenir for a fan that goes over the board. Get a souvenir football, and you get dapped up by Drew Prochaska. Great game, a great day for those guys along the boards. 11:15 to go in the first quarter of play. We'll get our first look at the Sioux City Bandits offense and quarterback Scott Jensen. Play call should come in quicker since Jensen is the offensive coordinator. Looks like head coach Irv Strobien is going to handle the offensive play calling with Jensen out there at quarterback. Just another pair of eyes. Let him know what he's seeing out there on the field. Get your starters for you for the Bandits. Break the huddle. Rashad Mungro, Omar Roberts, Stephen Fluker, your 3 linemen. Bruno and Owusu are going to go in motion. Prochaska, the running back, left hip pocket of Jensen. He sends him to the line. Sammy Epps out there as well. Jensen, low snap, looking over the middle of the field. Has Leslie Owusu overthrown, intercepted by Oklahoma. Big pick there. They're trying to return it the other way. There's a flag down on the other end as well. That's Mallory with it on the interception. He's eventually brought down by Leslie Owusu. There's a flag out there on the field. Just overthrown over the top of the hands of Leslie Owusu. Maybe a little too much adrenaline there for Scott Jensen, his first game back in a while. We'll see what this flying zone penalty flag is all about. Blindside block is the call. It's going to go against number 88 for Oklahoma. That's Karan Bolden. It's going to push him back a little bit, but a big play there for the Oklahoma defense after a 3-and-out on their opening drive. Get a big pick, first play of the Bandits opener. Now we get to see what the offense can do here. Carr Young is going to go empty set. Need a ball to play as the umpire finally brings it in. Be first and 10 from their own about 17-yard line. Big interception from LeBaron Mallory. Set up this drive. Carr Young takes a snap. Design quarterback run up the middle. Gets around a couple tacklers. Now Carlton Watkins wraps him up along the board. Xavier Spann as well. But a big run for Torrance. Carr Young. Gain of about 8. Brings up 2nd and 2. Oklahoma, after an opening drive that saw them go 3-and-out, big interception. Trying to get the offense rolling here on drive number 2. 2nd and 2 for the design run for Carr Young. Caldwell comes back into the backfield. Hand off to him, up the gut, gets through one tackler. He's eventually brought down, Carlton Watkins. It's going to be a fresh set of downs, though, for Oklahoma. And Anolo Caldwell, what will go into the books as his first carry of the game, as he had a run in the first possession that got called back due to a penalty for blocking the back. Check that, they'll go in the books as his 2nd carry of the game for Caldwell. 2 carries for 10 yards, average of 5 yards per carry right now for the running back. No pass completions yet for Oklahoma. See if that changes here. Carr Young takes the snap, looking left. Now he's going to run right up the middle. Uses Caldwell as a lead blocker. Mainz gets there to bring him down. Ball came out at the end. He was already down by the end of it. Okay, design quarterback draw up the middle with Caldwell as a lead blocker. Gain of about six there. Brings up second and four. They're inside the 15-yard line of the Bandits. Red zone starts at the 10. Breaks the huddle here for Oklahoma. Empty set here for Torrance Carr-Young. Davis and Langford on the line. Rashad Ridley going to go in motion. Carr-Young takes the snap, looking over the middle of the field. Finds a man. Gets away from a tackle from Braden Mines. First touchdown of the game is going to go for Oklahoma. That's Thomas Bingham, the wide receiver out of Tulsa. Breaks the tackle from Braden Mines. Spins out of it and gets into the end zone for six. And Oklahoma maybe stuns the Bandits here out of the gates with an interception on the Bandits' opening drive and now a touchdown here. 6-0, Oklahoma leads Sioux City with 8-12 and counting to go in this first quarter of play. That'll bring on Brandon Stewart to kick. Rashad Ridley to snap, Zuri Davis to hold, Stewart the kicker. Snap is good, hold is good. Stewart up, wide to the right. It will remain 6-0 off the rebound nets. Whistle blew, though, so it will not count. 7:46 to go in this first quarter of play. 6-0 your score. The Bandits offense gets to trot back out on the field when we return, or when they return. So we're going to get our first bit of fan engagement for the evening as well. We'll look into the stats from the opening couple drives. Not much for Sioux City. One play, one interception. A big pick from LeBaron Mallory. Set up a Oklahoma drive. Look at their offensive stats here, leading 6-0. Three carries for 18 yards for Torrance Carr-Young. Two carries for 10 yards for Manalo Caldwell. 1-for-1 in the passing game is Carr-Young as well. The wide receiver playing quarterback. 14-yard touchdown pitch and catch to Thomas Bingham out of Tulsa. Local college for him in Oklahoma. Big moment there. 6-0 your score after the missed kick from Brandon Stewart. Got some pedal car races down here on the field for Sioux City. Penalties are an issue right now, though, for Oklahoma. And you're going to have that having about 3 days of practice leading into your first game on the quick turnaround. Three penalties for 30 yards against Oklahoma. No penalties against the Bandits yet, but they do have that turnover. 36 yards of total offense for the Flying Aces. Zero right now in all statistical categories for the Sioux City Bandits on the offensive side of things. See what they come up with when they get back out there on the field offensively. Looks like Fred Bruno and Drew Prohaska are going to be the two that go back to return this kick. Stewart to kick for Oklahoma. Stewart's got the tee in his hands. Sets it down off the left side. Bruno and Prohaska were spread out around the 5-yard line. Now they're more bunched up. See exactly where they try to position this here. Both of them are dangerous in the kick return game. Stewart marches off his steps. Now three to his right, checks with his men. Now Bruno and Prohaska split. About the 3-yard line now they stand. Stewart with the run up, puts a boot through it. Driven kick going towards Prohaska, received at the 6-yard line. He cuts it back inside, looking for some blockers. Has a gap up the middle, cut down at the midway stripe. 24-yard line. They're going to say he got past the midfield stripe. First and 10 from the Oklahoma 25 here for the Bandits. Second offensive possession of the game for Sioux City. Scott Jensen leads the offense back out on the field. Gets a play call from his head coach, Irv Strobing. Day of potential massive milestones for Sioux City. Jensen stands at 199 passing touchdowns in his career, could go to 200. Head coach Irv Strobien stands at 99 victories in his career as well. Bruno goes in motion as well as Owusu. Handoff up the middle to Prochaska. Ripped down in the backfield by Bolden. He's able to spin forward for a couple yards, but that play was blown up in the backfield by Karan Bolden. Gain of just two on the play. Brings up second and eight. Every journey begins with a single step, but an opening play interception and a gain of just two on play number two. Down 6-0, not where the Bandits expected to find themselves with 6:46 and counting to go in the first quarter play. Jensen under center again, Prochaska the deep back. Owusu and Bruno in motion. This one's a jet sweep to Bruno off the right side. Gets through a couple tacklers, but eventually brought down at about the 16-17-yard line. It'll bring up second and short. They gave him a gain of six, so it'll be second and or third and two, excuse me. Third and a long two. Looks more like third and three. Jensen goes, brings the play call into the huddle. Back-to-back runs here for Sioux City, trying to establish the ground game. We'll see if they go to it again. Going to go shotgun here for Jensen. Prochaska on his left hip pocket. Bruno goes in motion as well as Owusu. Belt high snap. Fires quickly to Owusu. That's going to be a first down and more. The Bandits are in the red zone as he's brought down at the 9-yard line. First pass completion of the day for Scott Jensen, finding Leslie Owusu. Preseason game last week, Owusu had three catches for 22 yards and a long of nine. He averaged 7.3 per catch. Jensen going shotgun formation again with Prochaska on his left. Bruno and Owusu going in motion. Epps, the receiver, lined up on the line of scrimmage. Jensen takes the snap, looking right side. Sammy Epps, jump ball back to the end zone. There were three Oklahoma players there, only one Sammy Epps, and it goes into the fans for another souvenir. See what the Bandits draw up here on second and goal from the 9-yard line. They are inside the red zone, trailing 6-0 with 5:05 to go in this first quarter of play. Jensen going to go under center here. Prochaska the deep back. Owusu and Bruno in motion. Handoff in the middle of Prochaska. He's wrapped up in the backfield and brought down. Getting in there on the play for Oklahoma's number 44, Trey Smalls, blowing that one up in the backfield. Brings up third and goal from the 10-yard line now after a loss of one. Sioux City trying to get this offense working. The running game was working at first. It's been more of those jet sweeps that have worked, though. Jensen in the shotgun again, Prochaska on his right. Three receivers to the right as well. Bruno and Owusu going to go in motion, overloading that right side. Jensen going to look for somebody. Prochaska out of the backfield near the 5-yard line. Briggs and he's pushed up along the boards at about the two or three-yard line. Prochaska was pushed up along the board. So it's going to be fourth and goal. I see Braden Mines hopping over the boards. Usually signifies a power package. I can't quite see from my angle here. I'm opposite of our hard cam here inside the Tyson Event Center, but I believe there's a player down along the boards. They do get him back to his feet. Keontae Griffin, not someone you want to see coming off the field a little limp. Looks like the undershirt he's wearing. He's got a long sleeve undershirt on, also ripped on that left sleeve. Heavy contact along the boards. He's able to walk off under his own power. Not something you want to see no matter who you're a fan of. Injuries are no fun. There's no fan that comes to the game rooting for injuries. And if you do, I have several questions that I don't want to know the answer to. 3:54 to go, 6-0 your score. Oklahoma leads Sioux City in this first quarter of play. Fourth and goal from the 2-yard line. Scott Jensen, quarterback. This is a true power formation. Groenhagen, old school wishbone here. Groenhagen's a fullback. Mainz and Prochaska, two running backs. Sammy Epps, the lone wide receiver in the formation. And Oklahoma wants a timeout. Need to talk about this one. Not often you see the wishbone get broken out in indoor football. The Bandits were going to try it there. That's their power formation. 3:37 to go in the first quarter of play. 6-0, Oklahoma leads. Bandits have got the offense going on this drive after an opening play interception by Scott Jensen. 22 yards of offense now. They do have that turnover. Jensen is 2 for 4 with 15 yards. Bruno, the leading rusher right now, 1 carry for 7 yards on a jet sweep. Prohaska, they're going to give him a net 0 as he lost 1 and gained 1 on his 2 carries so far. As for receptions, Drew Prohaska does lead that category. 1 catch for 8 yards. That was out of the backfield. And Leslie Owusu has the other catch, 1 for 7 yards. More fan engagement here for the Sioux City Bandits. Always keeping the fans engaged, getting the fans involved. It's a great experience to come out here to the Tyson Event Center, be part of Sioux City Bandits football. The Bandits now break the huddle. They're ready to go. 4th and goal from the 2-yard line. They're going to that same wishbone power formation. Jensen going to go under center. Groenhagen, the fullback. Mainz and Prohaska. Split backfield. Sammy Epps, the lone wide receiver. Handoff up the middle. Drew Prohaska, he gets in there for 6. Drew Prohaska, his first touchdown of 2024. Ties this game up at 6 apiece for the Sioux City Bandits, pending the Jared Amundson extra point. Looks like Braden Mainz to snap this one. Lawnstein to hold. Amundson to kick. Right-footed kicker for Sioux City Amundson. Went 5 for 6 on extra points in the preseason game. Kick is good, up and off the right upright, no good. 0 for 1 to start this one on PAT tries. Makes him now 5 for 7 if you count last week's preseason game. He's shaking his head as he's walked out the field. He was nearly automatic last week. 6-6, the score remains, 2:55 to go after that 2-yard touchdown run by Drew Prohaska sealed that drive. Take a look at that drive. Took 4 minutes, 10 seconds off the clock, and 7 plays to go 24 yards. Ended in that 2-yard touchdown run for Drew Prohaska. We'll see if Oklahoma can answer here with 2:55 to go in quarter one. 6-6 the score. Flying Aces offense working well right now with quarterback Torrence Carr-Young. They've used more running game than anything right now to design quarterback runs for Carr-Young, but it was a pass that got them 6 on that last possession.
Be alert, football fans. The football or football player has a great deal of damage and we want to keep you safe. Please follow the game closely and understand them. The Bandits and staff, players, and management, along with Oklahoma Flying Aces, the NFL, and the
Rashad Ridley back deep to return for Oklahoma. Mainz tees it up. He's going to kick off for Sioux City. Mainz walks all the way back to the wall, then goes to his left. Kicked the first one away from Ridley. Went out of play. We'll see what Mainz does here. Boots this one straight away, end over end, near the rafters. Ridley's going to receive it in his own end zone. Got to play discipline here on kick coverage for Sioux City. One more forces him back inside, and Tyler Lawnstein, the quarterback, lays the hit. Something Lawnstein did last year as well. Plays in there on kick coverage when he's not on the field as a quarterback. Laid the boomstick there. 1st and 10 from their own 12-yard line. Decent return for Ridley. Thinking it just in front of his own boards in the back of his end zone to the 12-yard line. .230 and counting to go in this first quarter of play. Oklahoma 6, Sioux City 6. We're all tied up. Let's see what Torrence Carr-Young and this Flying Aces offense has up their sleeves on their third drive. First drive ended in a missed field goal. Second drive ended in a touchdown. See what they have here on drive number 3. Carr-Young sends his men to the line. Takes the snap, chest high, handoff up the middle to Caldwell. Gets away from Ossie Tapua and Braden Mainz. Eventually he slides down. Mines went over the top from behind him, and Carlton Watkins was in front of him. Gain of a couple there for Caldwell. A couple hard-fought yards. Brings up second and 8. Gronhagen, Vargas, and Tapua, the three down defensive linemen for Sioux City. Sherman Gilbert out there at corner with Xavier Spann, Carlton Watkins, Braden Mainz, and Juan Moore. Shotgun formation again here for Torrance Carr-Young. Belt high, snap, looks right side, fires quickly, finds Zeri Davis. Ball got knocked away at the end, but he was already down. They're going to say that was a completed pass. Xavier Spann in there on the tackle, brings up third and short. Spann and Watkins both advocating that it was an incompletion, but they're not going to give it to him. No, they are going to say it was incomplete. Looked like the far side from my position called it a catch. Now they're pushing them back. See in the replay, he did trap that one on the ground. Incomplete pass. Intended receiver was Zeri Davis. Very good receiver at this indoor football level. 10 seconds to go on the play clock as Torrance Carr-Young sends his men to the line. Chest high, snap, whistle's going to blow. Coach Loban wants a timeout. Didn't like how he saw something lined up. Quick timeout here for the Sioux City Bandits defense. Let's look at the offensive stats for the Oklahoma Flying Aces so far in this one. 38 yards of total offense, 2 first downs gained, 30 yards rushing, 8 yards through the air. Do have 3 penalties as well for 30 yards. Torrance Carr-Young is 1-for-2 with 14 yards and a touchdown. Could lose some yards on a sack taken earlier this game. He's also the leading rusher at 3 carries for 18 yards. Followed by Manalo Caldwell with 3 carries for 12 yards. Thomas Bingham has the lone reception of the game for Oklahoma. 1 catch, 14 yards, and a touchdown. Former Tulsa University standout. 3rd and 8 here. When both teams retake the field. Thank you for joining me here on the National Arena League YouTube page for NAL Week 1 action between the Flying Aces and the Sioux City Bandits. I am Braden Butler. Devin Gronhagen, Ossie Tapua, Aaron Roundtree out there as a defensive lineman as well. Torrance Carr-Young sends his men to the line, takes the snap. Blitzer coming up the middle. Braden Mainz caught. Pass. Pass was caught. Short of the first down marker and brought down by Xavier Spann. Mainz came through like he was shot out of a cannon up the middle. Carr-Young stood in there, took the contact, and found his man Langford for the catch. Brings up 4th and 3 here for Oklahoma. And it looks like they're going to let this one run to the end of quarter number 1. We'll be back in the second quarter of play to see what happens on 4th down for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. At the end of 1, it is tied up at 6-6. Again, your offensive stats in that first quarter, 43 yards of total offense for Oklahoma compared to just 24 for Sioux City. Also an interception, a turnover forced by the Oklahoma defense on the first play of the game. Looking at the Bandits' individual stats, Scott Jensen, 2-for-4 with a pick and 15 yards passing. Fred Bruno, one carry for 7 yards. Prohaska, 3 carries for 2 yards and a touchdown. Prohaska also the leading receivers at 1 catch for 8 yards, followed by Leslie Owusu, 1 catch for 7 yards. Thomas Bingham, your leading receiver for Oklahoma, 1 catch, 14 yards and a touchdown. William Langford, 1 catch for 5 yards, that one ending the first quarter of play. We switch sides of the field, still 4th and 3 when Oklahoma retakes the field. Right to the second quarter of play here in Sioux City. All right, check out here, Julio. Big fourth down play here for Torrance Carr-Young and the Flying Aces. He's going to go empty set, two receivers in motion. One of them, the running back Caldwell, sends him to the line. Coach Loban doesn't like something he sees. Be the second time out of the half taken by Sioux City. Using it with a full second quarter still to play, only one timeout left in this second half. Coach Loban did not like something he saw with how his defense was lined up. It is 6-6. This is a very important fourth and three play. It's closer to fourth and four. It's a long three here for Oklahoma if they want to get this one. Oklahoma Flying Aces and the Sioux City Bandits. The Bandits, one of the longest tenured teams in indoor football, regardless of league. This is their 25th season. Oklahoma laid dormant for a few years. Their last season as a team was the 2019 CIF year after the COVID-19 pandemic. They shut their doors for a little bit, come back this year, joining the National Arena League along with the Bandits and the Omaha Beef, Carolina Cobras, Idaho Horsemen, and the Colorado Spartans making up the rest of the NAL this season. Carr-Young, empty set again. Caldwell going to go in motion. Along with Langford. Carr-Young. A lot of flags fly, and they are going to blow that play dead. A lot of movement in the trenches. We'll see who moved first. They're going to get a false start on the offense. It's going to be against number 71, Big Ben Hughes out of Oklahoma State. Marching off 5 yards, makes it fourth and eight. We'll see what Oklahoma does here now. And it looks like now they're going to kick this one. See what leg Brandon Stewart has. He kicked it from his own end zone previously. I guess it was his own goal line last time. Prasco and Bruno go back deep. Spann and Justin Gilbert back there as well. They're a little shorter. They're about the 20-yard line. Prasco and Bruno in their own end zone. Now Spann creeps up. Tapua, Groenhagen, Vargas, and Mainz are going to try to get after this kick. Stewart lines it up. Now takes a couple steps to his right. Ridley to snap. Davis to hold. Snap good. Hold down, Stewart, end over end kick, drifting towards the board. Is going to be received at the 5-yard line by Drew Prohaska. He's got some space down the right side, cuts back inside, loses his footing for a moment. He's going to be ripped down by Rashad Ridley. He's going to get to the 24-yard line. Good little return there for Drew Prohaska. Sets up first and 10 at the Oklahoma 24-yard line for the Sioux City Bandits. Scott Jensen coming out at quarterback again. Still searching for career touchdown pass number 200. He's at 199. Just needs one today to get it. His head coach, Irv Strobing, who's talking to him right there, searching for career win number 100. If you look at his entire Bandits career, back in his playing days, he has more than 100 wins, but he's looking for win number 100 with the headset on. Jensen under center, Prohaska the deep back. Bruno goes in motion as well as Owusu, fakes the handoff. Jensen finding options, tries to go to Bruno right side, a little too high for Fred. Bruno goes off the right hand and into the bench area for Oklahoma. Brings up second and 10 here after the incompletion on that first play of this drive. Jensen getting the play call from his head coach, Irv Strobing. Going to go under center again here for Jensen. Owusu's going to go in motion. Prohaska the deep back. Bruno and Epps lined up on the line of scrimmage. Prohaska goes in motion with him. A little flip out to Prohaska. Whistle's going to blow. See what they get here. Coach Strobing not happy with it, so we can infer it's going against the Bandits. Offside. Oh, Strobe was just upset that they blew the play dead because he thought Prohaska had a large hole. That's going to go against Oklahoma. Brings up second and five after that penalty on the Flying Aces. Fourth penalty of the game against Oklahoma. 35 yards have been taken away from him. Shotgun formation for Jensen here with Prohaska on his left. Bruno and Owusu going to go in motion. Epps, the wide receiver on the line of scrimmage. Chest high snap. Jensen fires quick left side. Fred Bruno's there. Gets around, trying to get around one defender. He's shoved up along the boards. Play is going to get blown dead, but it's not before a first down into the red zone for the Sioux City Bandits. It's going to be first and goal from the 10-yard line.
First down.
The franchise getting him into the red zone. Jensen gets the play call from Strobeen and breaks the huddle. He's going to go under center here. Steven Fluker, the center for this Sioux City Bandits team. Rashad Mungro on his right. Omar Roberts on his left. Prohaska, the deep back. Jensen, jet sweep. Bruno off the right side looking for some space. He's knocked up along the boards hard, but he pops back to his feet. Franchise has seen his fair share of heavy contact. He's used to it in the indoor football game. Second and goal now for about the 7. 6-6, still your score. 12:29 and counting to go in the second quarter of play. Got a pair of touchdowns and a pair of missed extra points for both these teams. Jensen in the shotgun here. Prohaska on his right, Owusu and Bruno in motion. Sends him to the line now, does Jensen. Takes the snap, looking left side, trying to find somebody open. Back in the end zone, Fred Bruno high points the ball. There it is, number 200 for Scott Jensen. And of course, it goes to franchise Fred Bruno. One legend of the Bandits to another. And the Bandits players, the Bandits coaches are now on the field to congratulate Scott Jensen. 200 career passing touchdowns for the Sioux City Bandits. Unreal career for him. He's been a staple of the Bandits organization for over a decade, almost two decades now at this point. Don't want to date him too much. Now as an offensive coordinator, he's one of the best, if not the best, quarterbacks in franchise history. He's gonna keep that ball. That's not a souvenir for anybody, but maybe his kids someday. As Scott Jensen, career touchdown pass number 200. Well-deserved for a legend of the Bandits as they are honoring a legacy of legends this season. Snap is down, hold is down from Lonstein. Kick up, no good. Bounces away, and it's going to be blown dead. So that was off on the left side, off the rebound net. Amundsen not happy with himself, going 0-for-2 on extra points so far today. 12-6, your score after that touchdown pass from Scott Jensen to Fred Bruno. Looking at Jensen's stats here through the first quarter and change. 4-for-7, one pick, one touchdown, 32 yards passing. Fred Bruno, the leading rusher at 2 carries for 9 yards, followed by Drew Prohaska, 3 carries for 2 yards and a touchdown. Bruno also the leading receiver, 2 catches, 17 yards, and now a touchdown. The 200th touchdown of Scott Jensen's career. Where else was it supposed to go besides to Fred Bruno, back of the end zone for 6? More fan engagement here inside the Tyson Event Center. Jared Amundsen to kick off from his own goal line as we're getting back to play here inside the Tyson Event Center in Sioux City. Rashad Ridley will go back deep to return. 5'7", wide receiver. out of the South Dakota School of Mines. Great returner in the indoor game. Amundsen end over end kick, drifting towards the back sideline of the end zone. It's going to go out of play. Get the official ruling from the officials. Ball gets placed at the 20-yard line, first and 10. At their own 20 for Oklahoma. Torrence Carr-Young leads his men out in the field. Once again, take a look at his stats so far in this one. Two completions on three attempts for 19 yards and a touchdown. He's also their leading rusher at three carries for 18 yards with a long of nine. Thomas Bingham has the touchdown reception, one catch for 14 yards. William Langford has the other, one catch for 5 yards. Manolo Caldwell also has three catches for 12 yards. They got the Bandits defense. Braden Mines is their leader right now. Three tackles, one TFL, one sack. Carr-Young takes the snap, handoff. Rashad Ridley on the jet sweep, trying to find some space down that left side. He's going to find nothing. A gain of one, if anything. Devin Groenhagen there to wrap him up. Huddle gets broken for Oklahoma. Torrence Carr-Young in the shotgun. Manolo Caldwell on his right. It's like Ridley and Langford in motion. Fakes the jet sweep to Ridley. Carr-Young trying to find some space at the middle. Groenhagen's there again, as well as Mines. Juan Moore comes in trying to rip the ball away as Carr-Young did not go down to the turf easily. Gain of about half a yard brings up third and eight. To go in the second quarter of play. Torrence Carr-Young breaks the huddle, directing traffic and make sure his men are lined up correctly. Langford goes out wide to the left. Ridley's going to go in motion. Snap taken. Zervi Davis is the other one. They're looking for Davis deep down the left side. Xavier Spann is there. That one's overthrown out of play. It's going to bring up fourth and nine now for Oklahoma. We'll see what they do here. Check that, make it fourth and eight. Still a long way to go. They've been kicking in this situation early on. Fourth and anything more than six. They've taken a couple kicks for Oklahoma. We'll see what they do here. Looks like the offense is going to stay on the field. Check that, Brandon Stewart comes out of the bench area. They will kick. They got a little bit of time to set up, but it's still working against them. 13 seconds to go on the play clock. Stewart still buckling his chin strap. Prohaska and Bruno go back deep. Big scream down there from the bench from Carlton Watkins. He's hyped up. 4 seconds, 3 seconds. They got to get this quick. That's almost a delay of game. Stewart boots it away. It's drifting towards the back of the end zone. Picked up by Prohaska near the boards. To be wrapped up at the four by Rashad Ridley. Spins forward to the five. But good play there from Rashad Ridley. Special teams ace in more ways than one. Make sure Prohaska doesn't get any more yardage after a good return. Last time for Prohaska, set up a scoring drive for Sioux City. Scott Jensen back out there at quarterback again. Why stop at 200? He wants to go out there and get some more. Great player for this Bandits team. Started to settle in here. Knocked off a little bit of the rust with the opening drives. 8:05 and counting to go in the second quarter of play. Bandits lead 12-6 over Oklahoma. Jensen breaks the huddle. He's going to go shotgun in his own end zone. Prohaska on his left. Owusu and Bruno going to go in motion. When he sends them, now they go. Low snap around the knees. Jensen picks it up. He's in his own end zone looking for options. Tries to check it down to Prohaska, who's forced to make a quick pass there. A little more pressure than he would have liked from a pair of Oklahoma players. Like Trey Smalls was in there as well as Karan Bolden. Jensen breaks the huddle again. He's going to go under center this time for second and 10 from their own five for the Bandits. Prohaska the deep back. Bruno in motion. Handoff up the middle. Prohaska's wrapped up in the backfield by Bolden, trying to get forward for a couple yards. Prohaska was picked up by Bolden before they blew that whistle dead. Gain of about two or three there for Prohaska. Brings up third and long, though. See what the Bandits do here. Shotgun formation here for the Bandits. Jensen. Prohaska on his left. Sends Prohaska to the line. We're going to get a free play for Scott Jensen. He's going to uncork this one. Looking for Sammy Epps. Goes too far. Ended up in the arms of Draco Statham as he was falling backwards. But Jensen knew he had a free play, so just sent it downfield. And a 5-yard penalty against the defense brought to you by Flans Electronics. Third and a little more manageable here for the Bandits. I'm going to say long three, short four. Scott Jensen going to go under center here. Deep back Prohaska. Jensen sends his men to the line, takes the snap. Handoff, Fred Bruno on the jet sweep. Gets away from one tackler in Bolden. Has a first down and more. Fred Bruno gets to near the midfield stripe. They're going to say he's down at the 24, but it's a fresh set of downs for the Sioux City Bandits. First and 10 from their own 24-yard line. First and 10 for Sioux City from their own 24-yard line. Had the offense backed up a little bit, but a mistake made by the Oklahoma defense. Six penalties now against the Flying Aces for 45 yards. No penalties yet against Sioux City. Both teams even in the terms of total offense, 45 yards apiece. Jensen going to go under center. Prohaska the deep back. Sends Owusu and Bruno in motion. Hand off of the middle. Delayed handoff to Prohaska. Slips a little bit on the turf, but he manages to regain his footing. Gets past the 20 to about the 19, 18-yard line. Brings up second down for Sioux City. See, when Prohaska went into that jump cut there, lost his footing a little bit. He was looking to bounce that one outside, get along the boards maybe. Turf Monster put on an Oklahoma jersey for that play, and it caught Drew Prohaska. Still a good run. Brings up second and three from the 19. Jensen going to go under center with Prohaska, the deep back again. Jensen sends Owusu and Bruno the line. Play action, bootleg. Jensen looking for Fred Bruno. Right side, tough pass. Did he bring it in? Wait a minute. Fred Bruno able to make an immaculate catch in the back corner of the end zone. He's pleading his case with the officials. No ruling made yet. Bruno says touchdown. So do the rest of the Bandits. They feel a little biased here. The officials still conferring. The fans now letting people know they think it's a touchdown. It is. They're giving him a touchdown. Fred Bruno with another touchdown. Jensen makes it 18-6. They're more than likely going to have to take another look at that one. And there it is. The previous play is under review. When you take that long to make a decision, you know you're going to have to try to go back and take another look at it. As it stands, that was career touchdown pass, 201 for Scott Jensen, finding Fred Bruno down the right side, put it right where it needed to be. See how long this review takes here for National Arena League football. Thank you for joining me on the National Arena League YouTube page. I am Braden Butler for Sioux City Bandits football here. I've not put that touchdown on the board, so it remains 12-6. Pending review, could be 18-6. See how it all shakes out. Before that touchdown gets put on the board, Scott Jensen is 4-for-8 for 32 yards and a touchdown. Fred Bruno is leading receiver, 2 catches for 17 yards, has that opening touchdown. Bruno also the leading rusher, 3 carries for 21 yards. As for Oklahoma, Torrance Carr-Young, 2-for-4, 19 yards and a touchdown. He's also the leading receiver for 4 carries for 19 yards. Thomas Bingham, the leading receiver, 1 catch for 14 yards and a touchdown. Carr-Young, their leading rusher at 19 yards on those 4 carries. I've been giving a lot of love to the defense of either team statistically, so let's go take some looks at them. The leading tackler right now for Oklahoma is Lakeith Murray at 4 in the game. Arnell Anderson, the defensive back, wearing the number 0, 3 tackles and a pass breakup as well. Leon Smalls has the TFL, and LeBaron Mallory has 2 tackles and a pick. For the Bandits defense, Braden Mines, 4 tackles, 1 sack, 1 tackle for loss. Carlton Watkins and Devin Groenhagen have 3 tackles each, with Groenhagen having half a sack and half a TFL. 2 tackles for Xavier Spann, and then Juan Moore, Tyler Lawnstein, Ossie Tapua, Omar Roberts, David Vargas and Leslie Owusu all have one. Leon Smalls, Draco Statham, Austin Jones all have a tackle as well for Oklahoma. And judging by how the offense is set up, so the ball never hit the ground, but it did come uncontrolled from Fred Bruno and ended up hitting off the wall. So by rule, that is an incomplete pass. Great effort by Bruno. You can kind of see it there where it knocks off his left knee into the wall. Tough break for the Bandits. They're going back right away. Jensen with a quick pass out to Owusu gets a fresh set of downs. Striking from the record. He's still back at 200 career touchdown passes, but there's a fresh set of downs for Sioux City. First and 10 from the 13.
And that's good for the Sioux City Bandits.
Former Northern Iowa Panther Leslie Owusu, the rookie for this Bandits team, showing what he has to offer. Jensen's going to line up in the shotgun. Prohaska on his left. Bruno and Owusu in motion. Sends him in motion now. Jensen, low snap around the knees. Forced to roll out to his right. Looking back at the end zone. Fred Bruno's there. Great defensive effort made. That was Lakeith Murray, I believe, diving in with the right hand for another pass breakup. And it is Lakeith Murray. Great defensive play by him, knocking that one away in the back of the end zone. Could have been six for Fred Bruno. Remains 12-6, second down and 10 from the 13-yard line now for Sioux City. Back under center, or back in the shotgun, excuse me, goes Jensen. Little speed option off the left side. Prohaska gets inside the five, tries to bully his way through a couple of defenders. Did he get to the line? No signal yet from the officials. They're going to give it to him. Drew Prohaska, 5'8", 190 pounds. Doesn't matter. He can turn into a bowling ball when he wants to. And he knocked down a couple of defenders getting in there, able to stretch out at the end. They might review that one as well. Tough stretch at the end there for Prohaska. Looks like they're going to go for the extra point here. Tough running from Drew Prohaska. About three white jerseys on him as he stretches to the end zone. And now the previous play will go under review. Our second review in what feels like as many minutes. Back-to-back touchdowns for the Bandits might be swept off the board. The first one, the catch by Fred Bruno that was not after review. We'll see what they do here. If Prohaska was trying to stretch that one out at the end there. If Prohaska's not in, he's down at the half-yard line. So it's still a dangerous area for Sioux City. And I believe it's first and goal from the half-yard line as well. If they rule him down before he was able to stretch across the goal line. For the play to be reviewed here. 12-6 is the score if they don't put that touchdown on the board for the Bandits. Still waiting on the review here. We're over 90 seconds now, almost a minute 40 into this play review. Ball Ball has not been moved from where the PAT would come from. Now the referees come out. DJ Reese asking for confirmation from an official. They're going to take another touchdown off the board from review. They're going to say he's down just short. Now it's going to be first and goal from the 1 yard line for Sioux City here. Wouldn't be surprised if they just hand it off to Prohaska again here. They're going that power formation they had earlier, the first touchdown run by Prohaska. So it's Groenhagen as a fullback, Mainz and Prohaska split backfield. And they're going to go quarterback sneak up the middle for Scott Jensen. He's into the end zone for six. There's another touchdown for the Sioux City Bandits. This one from the quarterback, Scott Jensen. Makes it 18-6 now. Sioux City leads Oklahoma with 2:04 to go in the second quarter of play. Amundsen in to kick the extra point. Lonstein to hold. Mainz to snap. Amundsen's gone 0-2 so far on PATs after going 5-6 in game one. Referee stop play there for a second. Try to get a player off the field for Oklahoma. Now everybody's lined up. Snap is good, hold is down, kick up from Amundsen, and that one is good. Makes it 19-6 here at the Tyson Event Center in Sioux City, Iowa. The Bandits lead by 13 with 2:04 to go in quarter number two. Scott Jensen was going for career touchdown pass number 200 today. He got that one earlier on. He's 5-11 for 38 yards and a touchdown. Did have that pick on the opening play as well. He does now have one carry for 1 yard and a touchdown. Drew Prohaska, the leading rusher, he's overtaken Fred Bruno. Six carries for 23 yards. Bruno close behind, three carries for 21 yards. He's also the leading receiver is Fred Bruno. Two catches for 17 yards and a touchdown. For Oklahoma, Torrance Carr-Young, 2-4, 19 yards and a touchdown through the air. He also has 19 yards on the ground, averaging 4.8 yards per carry. Thomas Bingham has the touchdown catch for 14 yards. William Langford has the other reception for Oklahoma for 5 yards. Defensively for both these teams, Braden Mainz, the leading tackler for Sioux City, 4 tackles, 1 sack, 1 tackle for loss. Lakeith Murray, leading tackler for Oklahoma. 5 tackles. He had that pass breakup on the last drive as well, diving in the back of the end zone to knock it away from Fred Bruno. And a very good player, Arnell Anderson, right behind him with 4 tackles, 1 pass breakup. And LeBaron Mallory, 3 tackles, 1 pick. Carter Watkins and Devin Groenhagen each have 3 tackles for Sioux City, with Groenhagen contributing half a sack and half a TFL as well. Amundsen to kick off here. It's been Mainz originally handling the kickoff duties. Now it's Amundsen. Sends this one away, drifting towards the end line. It's going to be picked up by Rashad Ridley near his own goal line. He's going to bring it out near the 20 to the 22-yard line. It's going to be Tyler Lonstein who brings it in. Or brings them down for the tackle. First and 10. See, their own 21-yard line for Oklahoma here. Whistles, a lot of whistles blew at the end of that. Let's see what the referee has to say. So it was an offside on the kicking team, adding 10 yards to the end of the run. So it should bring it up to the 19-yard line of the Bandits. Very good field position to start for the Flying Aces here of Oklahoma. Thank you for joining me here on the National Arena League YouTube page this evening. I am Braden Butler as Torrance Carr takes the snap. Handoff up the gut to Caldwell. Manalo Caldwell gets about 4 or 5 yards on that one. They're going to give him 4, so he's down at the 15. Second and 6 from the 15-yard line. Juan Moore was in there on the tackle for Sioux City. 13-point ball game here in the second quarter of play. Shotgun formation for Torrance Carr-Young. He's got Caldwell on his right. Hand off another one up the gut to Caldwell. Runs into his own offensive lineman, and he's brought down by Ossie Tapua. Gain of one, if anything, on that one for Caldwell. They're going to give him one, so it brings up third and five. And it looks like Coach Loban. Saw Coach Loban signaling to the referees, thought he was calling timeout. No, it's a one-minute warning here. It's normal football timing rules for the remainder of the first half. 1 minute to go in the second quarter of play. Third and a long five, short six, whatever you want to call it for Oklahoma, as they trail by 13 when they retake the field. Look at some overall team stats for both these teams. Sioux City's offense has 8 first downs, 45 yards rushing, 38 yards passing for a total of 83. Oklahoma has 3 first downs on offense, 37 yards on the ground, 13 through the air for a total offense of 50. Penalties have been the big issue today for Oklahoma. 6 penalties in this first half already for 45 yards against. The Bandits only have 1 penalty for 10 yards. But the turnover battle is going in favor of Oklahoma. They have not turned the ball over yet compared to 1 for Sioux City. An interception on the opening play of the game by LeVere and Mallard. More fan engagement here in Sioux City. We'll see what the Bandits defense has drawn up. We'll see what the Flying Aces offense has drawn up. We return to action here shortly. National Arena League football. It's a lot of fun to be out here. It's my personal third season with the Bandits. First one in the National Arena League. Adjusting to some new rules, adjusting to the rebound nets. Also, the league itself made some adjustments with the amount of teams coming from the CIF to the National Arena League last year, adjusting some rules to make it more of a hybrid between indoor and arena football. Belt high snap to Torrance Carr-Young. He looks like he wasn't ready for it. He just takes off up the middle. He's going to be brought down just short of the line to gain. Even though it looked like a broken play, Carr-Young made something out of nothing and almost got the first down. It's fourth and short. Clock rolling, 40 seconds to go and counting. Fourth and short from their 10-yard line of the Sioux City Bandits. Coach Loban barking orders to his team. Timeout going to be taken here by Oklahoma. Want to sit back and talk this one over on fourth and short, a crucial fourth and short here. It's the second timeout of the half for Oklahoma. Doesn't look at any move for Brandon Stewart. He's taking a couple field goal opportunities from long ways away. Those usually come from the other end of the field. Oh for 3 on those kicks so far for Stewart. Missed one from 58, had 2 returns so far from 52 and 43. Prohaska's returned both of them. Offense is going to stay on the field, though, for Oklahoma. Fourth and short. Less than a yard remains between a fresh set of downs and a potential turnover on downs for Oklahoma. We'll see what Torrance Carr-Young and the Flying Aces offense has up their sleeves. Chest high snap, trying to run it off the left side. Quarterback power was broken up by Carlton Watkins and Devin Groenhagen. Ball came loose. Watkins picked it up. They're going to blow the play dead, though. Nobody tell Carlton Watkins that. He might think he just returned that one for 6. Carlton Watkins. Devin Groenhagen making a big play on the ball there, snuffing out that quarterback power off the left side. Gives a new set of downs to the Bandits for a turnover on downs. 23 seconds to go until we are at the halftime break. See if the Bandits can work a little magic here on offense. Scott Jensen still out there at quarterback from the looks of it. Prohaska, the running back. Bruno Epps and Owusu have been the wide receivers. Jensen breaks the huddle. He's going to be in the shotgun here. He's going to plant his heels at about his own 7-yard line. It's first and 10 from the 13. Bruno and Owusu in motion. Chest high snap. Jensen drops back, forced to scramble up the middle, get away from some defenders. He's launching it downfield. That one might just be a throwaway there, as the closest receiver was Leslie Owusu, who is still a couple yards away from the ball as it hit the turf. Second and 10 now from the 13 for the Bandits. 16 seconds to go in this second quarter of play. They lead by 13 to Sioux City. 19-6, your score. Two touchdowns on the ground, one touchdown through the air for the Bandits offense. Jensen hooked up with Fred Bruno for the touchdown pass, his 200th in his career for Scott Jensen. He's also got a rushing touchdown for the quarterback, and Drew Prohaska has the other rushing touchdown on the ground. Jensen in the shotgun, Prohaska on his right hip pocket, sends Bruno and Mainz to the line. Braden Mainz out there at wide receiver, Swiss Army knife doing it all. Jensen forced to roll to his right, firing it downfield. He's looking for Drew Prohaska, Draco Statham there as well. That one was out of play. Neither of them could get to it. It's going to be a souvenir for some fans down that sideline. Near section 102 here at the Tyson Event Center. Third and 10 now with 7 seconds remaining. See how much of a cannon Scott Jensen has potentially here. You know how condensed this field is. You could play it short, get a timeout off. There's still one remaining for the Bandits. See what they do. Jensen takes the snap. About belly high. He's going to launch this one into the stratosphere near the rafters. Jump ball opportunity. Who's coming down with it? Nobody comes down with it. And that is how we end the first half of play. A Hail Mary attempt there from Scott Jensen leads to the ball hitting the turf inside the Tyson Event Center. 19-6, your score at the half. The Bandits lead by 13 here in Sioux City. It's week one of the National Arena League. Thank you for joining us here today so far. I am Braden Butler. So we go into the halftime break here. Let's take a look at stats for both these teams. We'll start offensively with the Oklahoma Flying Aces. They trail 19-6. Their touchdown came on the second drive of the game for Oklahoma. A touchdown connection from Torrance Carr-Young to Thomas Bingham for 14 yards and a touchdown. That is one of two completions today from Torrance Carr-Young, who's not traditionally a quarterback for this Flying Aces team, but there's some changes that had to be made, some last-minute adjustments that had to be made at the quarterback position. Torrance Carr-Young stepped in. He's been doing a good job in the running game as well. 6 carries for 21 yards. He's the leading rusher, followed closely by Manalo Caldwell, who has 5 carries for 17 yards. Bingham, that one catch for 14 yards and a touchdown, and William Langford has 1 catch for 5 yards. Looking at the Bandits, Scott Jensen has 5 completions on 14 attempts and 1 interception. That came back on the opening play of the game for 38 yards and 1 touchdown. His leading receiver is Fred Bruno right now, 2 catches for 17 yards and a touchdown. Leslie Owusu following closely with 2 catches for 13 yards. And Drew Prohaska has 1 catch for 8 yards. Drew Prohaska, the leading rusher for this Bandits team, 6 carries, 23 yards, and a touchdown with a long of 12. Fred Bruno, 3 carries for 21 yards, 7 yards per carry right now for the franchise. And Scott Jensen, 1 rush on a quarterback sneak from the 1 yard line, got in there for 6. Jensen got his 200th career touchdown pass earlier today as well on that completion of Fred Bruno back in the first half of play. During this halftime break, we're going to have some multiple fan engagement segments. We'll go off mic for a little bit here inside the Tyson Event Center. We'll come back shortly, keep things rolling here at halftime, and then bring you the second half of action. It's week one of the National Arena League. The Sioux City Bandits taking on the Oklahoma Flying Aces. 19-6, your score. Sioux City leads by 13. I'm Braden Butler. Don't go anywhere. Keep it tuned right here for the National Arena League on YouTube.
It's close.
Welcome back in here, ladies and gentlemen, for National Arena League Football. We are at halftime of this matchup between the Sioux City Bandits and the Oklahoma Flying Aces. 19-6 your score. Sioux City leads by 13 at the halftime break. One touchdown in this game for Oklahoma came from quarterback Torrance Carr-Young as he found his receiver Thomas Bingham out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, out of Tulsa University. That was the opening touchdown for Oklahoma. Was the opening touchdown of the game, too. That was 14 yards out. It's been all Bandits since then. 19 unanswered for the Sioux City Bandits, including the 200th career touchdown pass of legendary quarterback Scott Jensen. Let's take a look around the NAL right now. There's one other game going on at this moment out in Idaho at the Fort Idaho Center out in Nampa. The Idaho Horsemen are leading the Carolina Cobras, one of the new kids on the block in the Horsemen against the established NAL team, Carolina. The Horsemen up 13-7 in that one out in Idaho. Interesting how that one is turning out, maybe shocking a couple folks. Idaho playing very well here to start. Guy Myers, the quarterback for Carolina, is 5-for-7 in that one so far with a touchdown pass, 37 yards through the air. The recipient of that touchdown pass is not listed, interestingly, on these stats. I digress there, though. Carolina trailing 13-7 to the Idaho Horsemen. That one taking place out in Nampa. Interesting to see how that one shakes out at the end of it here. 19-6, your score once again here in Sioux City. Oklahoma trailing the Sioux City Bandits. YMCA playing through the loudspeakers here at the Tyson Event Center. The village people will never cease to get people on their feet. It does not matter the age, anything. Very few things bring people together like the YMCA, and I'll tell you that right now. Let's take a look at our stats again from this one. A little recap here. We went over them at the start of the halftime break, but if you tune in a little late, maybe you're jumping back and forth here in the National Arena League between our game here and the game between Idaho and Carolina. Thank you for joining us for while you are here. 5-for-14 with one interception, one touchdown, and 38 yards for quarterback Scott Jensen. His leading receiver is Fred Bruno, 2 catches for 17 yards and a touchdown, followed by Leslie Owusu, 2 catches for 13 yards. Drew Prohaska has 1 catch for 8 yards. In the rushing game, Drew Prohaska leading that with 6 carries for 23 yards and a touchdown. Fred Bruno has 3 carries for 21 yards, 7 yards per carry. And Scott Jensen has a quarterback sneak from the goal line, 1 carry, 1 yard for a touchdown. Looking offensively for the Oklahoma Flying Aces, Torrance Carr-Young, 2-for-4 for 19 yards and a touchdown. Also their leading rusher at 6 carries for 21 yards, followed closely by Manalo Caldwell, 5 carries for 17 yards, 1 catch for Thomas Bingham, 14 yards for a touchdown, and 1 catch for William Langford for 5 yards. Looking defensively for both these teams, we'll start with the Flying Aces. Lakeith Murray, 5 tackles with a pass breakup as well. That one in the back of the end zone, one of the final drives of the Bandits in that first half. Could have been a sure touchdown to Fred Bruno if he doesn't dive in and get a paw on it. Arnell Anderson has 4 tackles for the pass breakup as well, right up there with Murray. LeBaron Mallory has an interception, the first play of the game for Sioux City. First play of the Sioux City offense, LeBaron Murray picked it up. Mallory picked it off for Oklahoma. He's got 3 tackles as well. Caron Bolden, Rashad Ridley, and Keontae Griffin each have 2 tackles. Leon Smalls, Austin Jones, and Draco Statham all have a tackle with TFL as well. For the defensive side for the Bandits, Braden Mintz, 5 tackles, 1 sack, 1.5 TFLs. He's leading the charge on the defensive end. Carlton Watkins with 4 tackles and 0.5 TFL as well. Juan Moore, Ossie Tapua, Devin Groenhagen, each with 3 tackles apiece. Tapua and Groenhagen combining for 0.5 sack and 0.5 TFL as well. 2 tackles for Xavier Spann and Tyler Lonstein. 1 tackle for Omar Roberts, Sherman Gilbert, David Vargas, and Leslie Owusu. We're getting ready to get back underway here. Second half of action coming up here on the National Arena League YouTube page. Thank you for joining me this evening. I am Braden Butler. 19-6 your score. Bandits lead by 13 against the team of the Oklahoma Flying Aces. We've been dormant for a few years. Now they're back and ready to roll in the National Arena League. The Bandits, one of the longest tenured indoor football franchises in the country. 25th season this year for the Bandits. The other one right up there with them is their longtime rivals in the Omaha Beef. Manis did kick to start this game, so it will be Oklahoma kicking off in this second half. Back deep to return will be Drew Prohaska and Fred Bruno. Aussie Tapua, Devin Groenhagen, Carlton Watkins, Sherman Gilbert, Braden Mintz, and Sammy Epps also out there on the kick return. Brandon Stewart to kick off for Oklahoma. Stewart puts the tee down. We are ready to get rolling with a second half of action from Sioux City, Iowa, the Tyson Event Center. The Bandits went down 6-0 in this one early. A touchdown pass from Torrance Carr Young to Thomas Bingham. Been 19 on answer for the Bandits. They're trying to keep that momentum rolling here in the second half of play. The left-footed Stewart starts his run-up. Low driven kick goes into Aussie Tapua at the midfield stripe. Tapua going to get up with it, get past the 15 to about the 12-yard line. Aussie Tapua, the defensive lineman out of Briar Cliff. I'm actually going to say he's down at the 14. Either way, still great starting field position for the Bandits as they tried to catch the Bandits napping. And Aussie Tapua stayed awake for it. Scott Jensen back out there at quarterback. First and 10 from the 14-yard line. Prohaska, the running back. Once Jensen breaks the huddle. Just watch a player go back to the locker room for Oklahoma. No, hopefully it's no injury, just an equipment issue. It looks like Zuri Davis. Jensen takes the snap. Handoff, Drew Prohaska off the right side. He is upended and plopped backwards, but he gains about 3 to 4 yards. Give him a gain of 3, brings up 2nd and 7. Davis back out of the locker room. Looked like it was just an equipment thing. Good to see Zuri Davis, a good player for this Oklahoma team. Jensen going to go under center again here for the Bandits. Prohaska the deep back, Owusu and Bruno now go in motion. Jet sweep Bruno off the left side. He's got some blockers trying to find the space. Gets inside the 5 near the goal line. They're going to say he's down at about the 2, maybe the 3. But it's going to be first and goal from the Bandits from wherever they spot it. As Fred Bruno gets the jet sweep off the left side and takes it inside the 10-yard line. Looks like they're going power formation for the Bandits. Mintz and Groenhagen jump over the wall. Bruno and Owusu coming off. Jensen under center. Groenhagen is a fullback. Split backfield behind him. Prohaska and Mintz. Handoff to Mintz off the left side. Brayton Mintz puts the shoulder down. The Swiss Army knife gets in there for 6. And he puts the Bandits up 25-6, pending the extra point. 25 unanswered from this Bandits offense after they went down 6-0 early. Their first possession of half number 2, much more successful than their first half of their first possession of half number 1. Been working through it of these Bandits offense. 25-6 pending the Amundsen extra point. 12:35 to go in quarter number 3. And counting. Launstein to hold. Snap is good. Hold is down. Amundsen kick up and no good off of the metal stanchion here, holding the nets up, the rebound nets up here at the Tyson Event Center. Makes it 25-6 is what it will remain. Get a drive summary for that final, for that last drive for the Bandits. Took only a minute 53 off the clock. 3 plays to go 14 yards after a short kick ended up in the arms of Aussie Tapua, and he returned it to the 14-yard line. 3 plays, 14 yards, ending in that touchdown handoff to Braden Mintz off the left side. Running game worked well in that one. It was all runs for the Bandits in that opening drive. 3-yard carry for Prohaska, 8-yard carry for Bruno, and then finally a 3-yard touchdown run for Mintz. 12:21 to go, quarter number three, 25-6. Sioux City now leads 25 unanswered on the board for the Bandits. Braden Mainz to kick off here. Haven't seen that deuce rule come into effect yet this year for the Bandits. Between their preseason game and the first half of this game, plus a couple minutes. See if Mainz goes for it here. He does have quite a boot. Sends this one end over end, drifting towards the end zone. It's going to come up short. Rashad Ridley returns it just in front of the boards in his own end zone. Now he cuts back out left side. Gets chopped down near the 14-yard line. Looks like Sherman Gilbert was in there on the hit. Can I bring up? Another offside going against the kicking team in the Sioux City Bandits. Adds another 10 yards. That's a penalty flag brought to you by Flans Electronics. First and 10 for Oklahoma here, now from their own 24-yard line after that penalty gets assessed against the Bandits. Torrance Carr Young in the shotgun. Sends a couple men to the line in motion. Handoff, no. Read option off the right side. Carr Young trying to get away from Mainz. High on the grab there. Almost a horse collar. Not going to throw a flag on it. Gain of about four for Torrance Carr Young off the right side on what was a read option. They're going to say it was around the shoulder is where Mainz grabbed. He's eventually brought down by Justin Gilbert. Second down here for Oklahoma as the play call comes in for Torrance Carr Young in this Oklahoma offense. See what Carr Young has up his sleeve here. Empty set. Bingham and Ridley going to go in motion. Hand off to Ridley. Jet sweep off the left side. He's got some space. Got a couple blockers. He's eventually ripped down, though. Just short of the line to gain. Going to bring up third and about two. Looks like Carlton Watkins was in there on the tackle. It was Juan Moore coming in over top. The 6'5" defensive back, Juan Moore.
And it's third down.
Third down here at about two to go. See what they go for here. Carr Young, handoff, no. Jets, or read option off the left side. He gets the first down and Moore. Breaks a tackle in the backfield from Braden Mainz. Xavier Spann and Juan Moore eventually get the quarterback to the turf, but it's going to bring up a fresh set of downs. First and 10 from about the 12-yard line. There is an opportunity at a first down still to get into a goal-to-go situation. Torrance Carr Young in the shotgun. Caldwell on his left. Men go in motion to the line. Fakes the handoff, now going back at the end zone. Zuri Davis is there. It's going to be too high for everybody. Ends up being a souvenir for a young fan. Second and 10 now for Oklahoma. At the end of the play there, look, there's a bit of exchanging of words between Justin Gilbert and the receiver, Zuri Davis. I know if Gilbert maybe thought Davis brought it in, he was trying to go back up and knock it out or what, but he pulled the hands back immediately. Empty set for Carr Young. Looking left side, now forced to scramble out to his right. Gets away from Braden Mainz. Devin Groenhagen as well, can't get him. Now Torrance Carr Young, one man to beat, brought down by Juan Moore. Sure tackling there from Moore, the defensive back. But what could have been a big loss for Torrance Carr Young ends up to make it a third and manageable situation. Gets away from Mainz in the backfield. Just missed on the tackle attempt from Devin Groenhagen. Showing the fancy footwork for Torrance. Lawrence Carr Young, the quarterback, was brought into Oklahoma as a wide receiver. Takes the snap chest high, fakes the handoff, now goes left side. It's a pass to the offensive lineman, designated himself as a receiver, gain of a couple. As I was saying about Torrance Carr Young, came in as a wide receiver, had two quarterbacks on the roster for Oklahoma originally. One of them signed on elsewhere. It was amicable split with the team from what I was told. The other one was not available to play yet, as Oklahoma was supposed to start their season in about three more weeks. But due to rescheduling with the NAL, another quarterback not available. So Torrance Carr Young steps in his place. For someone who's not primarily a quarterback, Carr Young, 2 for 5, 19 yards and a touchdown in this one. A flag is thrown. See what happens here. Got a sideline warning against the Sioux City coaches. Still fourth and short here from inside the 5-yard line. We'll see what Torrance Carr Young has here. Empty set. Takes the snap, design quarterback run left side. Devin Groenhagen is there. He's trying to get away. They're going to blow the whistle. Forward momentum was stopped. They'll scuffle after the play, but it's all clean. Devin Groenhagen, the long arm of the law, brings him down in the backfield. It'll be first and 10 Bandits when they dip back out on the field on offense. Great stop there for Devin Groenhagen and this Sioux City Bandits defense. As the Bandits offense retakes the field, let's look at their offensive stats on the opening drive of this third quarter. It was all runs on this third quarter drive for the Bandits to start. Drew Prohaska got a 3-yard run from the 14 to the 11. Fred Bruno got him down inside the 5-yard line and a fresh set of downs with an 8-yard run off the left side. And then Braden Mainz, so it went to a power formation, punched it in for the final 3 yards. Only took about a minute 50 off the clock for Sioux City on their opening drive. 25 unanswered points are on the board for the Bandits after going down 6-0 early. Bandits started out a little slow. It was the duality for this Sioux City Bandits team. The opening possession of their game last week, their preseason game against Minneapolis, the Bandits defense got an interception on the first play of the game. The Bandits offense, their opening possession today, threw a pick, and that was what helped set up a touchdown for Oklahoma. It's been all Bandits ever since then. Scott Jensen settling back in. The legendary quarterback captured his 200th career touchdown pass. Irv Strobing going for his 100th career win as well as a head coach. This is Iowa Corn Agriculture Appreciation Night as well. Inside the Tyson. Pitch out. Drew Prohaska left side. Cuts back inside. Puts the shoulder down. Gets through a defender. Brought down after a gain of about 4 or 5. It'll bring up 2nd and 5 here for the Bandits. .620 and counting here in quarter number 3. Head coach Irv Strobing talking to his quarterback and offensive coordinator Scott Jensen. Not letting him wear a headset under that helmet. Don't know how it would fit. You need to get an extra large helmet to put a headset on under there, but I digress. These are the headsets they usually wear on the coaching staff. Jensen under center. Deep back Prohaska. Quick pass out to Sammy Epps on the screen play, trying to get some lead blockers. No space there. He's wrapped up and swung into the boards by Karan Bolden. Big tackle there. Gain of nothing, if anything. Change being made here at the wide receiver position. Leslie Owusu coming out. We'll see who all steps in his place. It looks like Braden Mintz will line up at receiver. So it's going to be Mintz and Bruno, the receivers that go in motion. Prohaska, the running back on the right side of the shotgun formation for Scott Jensen. Sammy Epps on the line of scrimmage. Jensen, knee-high snap. Pump fakes again. Now forced to scramble out. Right side, looking downfield. He's going to launch it downfield. Sammy Epps trying to get up there. Pass knocked away, almost intercepted by Oklahoma. Didn't quite catch the jersey number as he was going over the top there. That was LeBaron Mallory. Almost had his second pick of the game for Mallory. As a little bit of a scramble drill for Scott Jensen turned into a deep shot. Now fourth and five from their own 13. It looks like the kicking team is out there. Let's see how far Amundsen can kick it here. He had a collegiate long of 44 yards during his time at Morningside. This one, he's going to line up at about his own 5-yard line. It's going to be a little more than that. This one, Buda's going towards the corner. It's going to be received outside of the end zone by Draco Statham. Almost brought down, but he's going to find some space on the left side. Stephen Fluker there can't get him. Amundsen can't get him. Statham was pushed up along the boards. But Draco Statham with a big play there in the kick return game. We talked about him as a defensive back, as a player to watch for this Flying Aces team. Made a big play there in the kick return. Sets up first and 10 from about the, where are they going to spot him at? Oh, they're going to say he hit the boards way before I thought he did. It's going to be first and 10 from their own 22. Running down that left sideline along the boards, it can be a dangerous situation. You're allowed to bounce off the boards if you are untouched, but if you're pushed up against the boards, then it is a dead ball. Empty set here for Torrance Carr-Young. Plenty of time still on the play clock as he sends his men to the line. Chest high snap, looking right side, firing downfield for Zuri Davis. That's going to end up in the Bandits bench. Looking like maybe a miscommunication there as Davis was taking that route all the way to the end zone. Carr-Young maybe expecting him to come back on it. It's one of those things where, unfortunately for Oklahoma, they haven't had a lot of time to gel together due to the rescheduling. Their camp started earlier this week. They were supposed to get a couple weeks of camp in before their first game. Original National Arena League schedule didn't have Oklahoma playing until almost April. Now it's March 15th. They come into camp early, led to some shifts around on the team. Some guys are unavailable as of right now. Low snap for Carr-Young, finds Caldwell on the right side. The running back, Manolo Caldwell, makes a couple men miss. The shifty footwork outside, he's going to be wrapped up along the boards, knocked up along the boards. But it's going to be first and goal for Oklahoma. Torrance Carr-Young on the check down finds Manolo Caldwell and runs it down the right sideline. First and goal from about the 2-yard line. Torrance Carr-Young now 4 for 8 for 46 yards and a touchdown. Not such bad numbers for a guy who's not a quarterback by nature. Carr-Young takes the snap, QB power right up the middle, and he gets into the end zone. It breaks the 25-point scoring streak for the Bandits and now puts 12 points on the board for Oklahoma. Pending an extra point opportunity here, they trail by 13, could make it 12, could make it 11 as well if they go for two. Looks like they're sending the kicker, Brandon Stewart, out there, the left-footed kicker. Zuri Davis to hold, Rashad Ridley to snap, and Stewart to kick. 25-12 your score, just under a minute 40 to go here in the third quarter of play. Snap is good, hold is good. Stewart, kick up, wide to the left off the rebound net. It's going to bring us to a minute 27 to go in the third quarter of play, and we got immediate timeout. Let's take a look at that last drive for the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Started with 4:22 to go in the quarter. 2 minutes and 10 seconds off the board. Three plays for 28 yards. Ended in that touchdown run from Torrance Carr Young. Carr Young now has 11 carries for 36 yards in that touchdown. He's also 4 for 8 through the air for 46 yards and a touchdown. His leading receiver is now Manalo Caldwell. One catch for 26 yards, the longest of the day coming on that last drive. And his defense was just on the field. Their leader in tackles now is the tie between Juan Moore and Braden Mainz with 6 apiece. Mainz adding 1 sack and 1.5 TFLs. LeBaron Mallory, Lakeith Murray, and Arnell Anderson each have 5 tackles for the Flying Aces, as well as a pass breakup for each. And Mallory has an interception, almost had 2 on that last Bandits offensive possession. Other standouts for both these teams on the defensive side, Caron Bolden and Draco Statham each have 3 tackles. Rashad Ridley, Keontae Griffin, and Austin Jones. I know Ridley, a wide receiver, but he's got a couple tackles out there on special teams, as well as Griffin and Jones, each with 2 apiece. Leon Small, 1 tackle for 1 TFL. For Sioux City, other players for them, Carlton Watkins has 5 tackles and half a TFL. Devin Groenhagen has 4 tackles, half a sack, and 1.5 TFLs. Xavier Spann and Aussie Tapua each have 3 tackles apiece, with Tapua adding half a sack and half of a TFL. Tyler Launstein, Sherman Gilbert with 2 apiece as well in the tackle department. We have another update from out west in Idaho. The Idaho Horsemen currently lead the Carolina Cobras 21-16. That one's taking place out of the Ford Idaho Center in Nampa. Carolina, a team that was picked by a lot of people to finish highly in the National Arena League. Idaho Horsemen had unknowns about them, had a couple question marks stepping up to the National Arena League from their previous situation. Could be announcing themselves on a national stage right now as they lead by 5 over Carolina. Brandon Stewart to kick off here. Back deep to return is Drew Prohaska and Fred Bruno for Sioux City. Bruno and Prohaska sharing a little chit-chat about the 3-yard line. Stewart takes his steps back, now walks off to his right. Getting a little, instead of splitting apart, Bruno's going to stay at about the 3, and perhaps he's going to go back deeper into the end zone. Stewart, low-driven kick, bounces about the midfield stripe, bounces again. Bruno can't pick it up cleanly, now gets it at the 5, loses his footing a little bit, cuts back outside. Fred Bruno still got the footwork, gets tackled, though, from behind by Draco Statham. Fred Bruno, everything went wrong, and then it went right, and then it was ended. And Bruno knows it, too. If he was able to break out that last tackle by Statham, he might be dancing in the end zone right now, even after everything that started at first. Because there was a gap. If he's able to get past Statham, and then Lakeith Murray was in there as well, number 4, trying to wrap him up with an arm tackle. If he's able to get away from that, could be talking 6 for the Bandits on a house call. 25-12, your score, 51 seconds and counting to go in the third quarter of play. Jensen still under center, Prohaska the deep back. Bruno goes in motion as well as Owusu. Hand off to Bruno off the right side. Nothing doing there. Caron Bolden blew that play up in the backfield. Bolden was there first. Arnell Anderson was in there as well. Big defensive stop there for Oklahoma. 25 seconds to go and counting. The Bandits don't have to run another play in this third quarter, but we'll see if they do. Jensen breaks the huddle. 20 seconds on the play clock, 14 on the game clock. Jensen's going to line up under center with under 10 to go in the third quarter. Send a couple men in motion. Fakes the handoff. Now dumps it down. Drew Prochaska. And that one with the pressure coming down in his face. That's Manolo Caldwell, the running back, who was sent there on a blitz. Forced to get it away and was out of reach of Drew Prochaska. That brings us to the fourth quarter of play. 25-12. Oklahoma trails Sioux City by 13 here inside the Tyson Event Center. It started out 6-0 Oklahoma, 25 unanswered, followed for Sioux City. But a touchdown run on the last possession for Oklahoma got it back to a 13-point game. 25-12, we head into the fourth. This is National Arena League Football. Sioux City Bandits taking on the Oklahoma Flying Aces. Give a team stat recap as we go into the fourth quarter of play here for National Arena League Football. Thank you for joining me. I am Braden Butler. The Sioux City Bandits lead 25-12 over the Oklahoma Flying Aces. The Bandits have 10 first downs in this game compared to 6 for the Aces. 15 carries for 63 yards for Sioux City, 18 carries for 59 yards rushing for the Flying Aces. 38 yards through the air for Sioux City, 40 yards through the air for Oklahoma. 6 completions on 17 attempts and an interception for Sioux City right now. 4 completions on 8 attempts, no interceptions for Oklahoma. Possession time is about even as well. Jensen in the shotgun, takes the snap low, forced to roll out to his right. He's going to get sacked in the backfield and brought down. That was Arnell Anderson getting in there in the backfield, bringing down the quarterback. Not how the Bandits wanted to start the fourth quarter of play. That brings fourth and very long in. And that means Jared Amundson is going to try to boot this one as far as he can. Lakeith Murray back deep for Oklahoma. We'll see how far Amundson can kick it here. Snap is good. Hold is down. This one. It's going to end up near the Sioux City bench in the tunnel area. It's going to be first and 10 for Oklahoma here. From the midfield stripe, from the looks of this, where they're sparring. No, now they're moving it back. They say it went out around the 15. Chain Gang was initially setting up at the 25. Hard to tell when exactly it crosses over the boards from my angle. See what Oklahoma has here. First and 10, they trail by 13. Carr Young in the shotgun. Caldwell on his right, takes the snap, handoff to Caldwell up the middle, bounces it back outside. He's brought down from behind by Ossie Tapua. Gain of about 3, and Caldwell, a little slow to get up there, not something you want to see if you're Oklahoma. He signaled to the sideline real quick. See if they can give him a play off. He was brought down hard from behind, maybe drove the wind out of him here. A couple kids in the stands are wearing Halloween costumes. Nobody tell them it's March. I love it when kids have fun. Carr Young in the shotgun. Empty set. Pitches out quickly to Rashad Ridley on the right side. It's basically a speed pitch from a wide receiver getting a running start. Gets a couple yards there. Brings up third and short. Smart play design there. You want to get that ball into Rashad Ridley's hands any way you can. Ridley in this one has 3 kick returns for 59 yards on his stat sheet. Carr Young, empty set. They're going to do the same thing. Left side to Ridley. He's going to almost get brought down in the backfield, but he's actually going to get enough for the first down. Is he dodged the outstretched arm of Devin Groenhagen and gets a new set of downs. Rashad Ridley. Another carry for him. Brings up a new set of downs for Oklahoma. Breaking out some new plays here in the fourth quarter. It's only a two-score game. The final minute of this quarter will be normal football timing rules as well. A lot of crazy things can happen in that final minute. Carr Young in the shotgun again. Empty set. He's got his feet planted at his own 20-yard line. Ball is at the Bandits 24. Carr Young looking deep downfield. Rashad Ridley wide open at the 5-yard line. Gets in there for six. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Torrence Carr Young finds Rashad Ridley. He finds the gap in the Bandits' defense. Catches it about the 4-yard line. It gets into the end zone. Just like that, it's become a one-score game. 25-18. Bandits only up by 7. Oklahoma not going away. Update on the game between Carolina and Idaho. Carolina recently took the lead, 23-21 now the score out there. Cobras up on the Horsemen. Brandon Stewart marching off his steps for the extra point here. Zuri Davis to hold. Snap is good. Hold is down. Kick up from Stewart. Wide to the left and goes out of play. Flag down in the backfield, though, and judging from the looks of it with Groenhagen and Stewart on the turf, I think we might get a roughing. Half the distance to the goal, and we will retry the point. PAT was no good. It's a flan zone penalty flag here in Sioux City. And it looks like they're going to go for two now for Oklahoma. Make it a 5-point game if they get it. If they don't get it, it's still a 7-point game. Could put them in an interesting position where all you need is six to potentially win the game. Torrence Carr Young. We got four linemen basically on the field right now. Carr Young is going to take the snap, fake the handoff. It's going to be a power run up the middle. He's going to be stood up at the goal line, fighting forward, trying to get some yardage. They're going to say no. His progress was stopped before he got in. There's a pile of bodies. There's also a little bit of laundry on the field. So we're going to have another penalty flag brought to you by Flanzone. See exactly what it is. There's a couple Oklahoma players who are still trying to find the right spots to line up. Didn't look like there was enough to get it anyway, so the Bandits, unless it would add yardage to the kickoff, might just decline this one and go to a kickoff. Legal formation was the call. Penalty is declined. The score stays 25-18 here in Sioux City. Seven-point game here in the fourth quarter of play. 10-18 to go in the fourth. Bandits offense set to retake the field after this kickoff, barring a return or a turnover. See Braden Mice down there on the field right now. You can tell he's not afraid of contact. The logo is peeling off the side of the helmet. Playing linebacker, you are going to see a lot of contact, and he's definitely found his way to it tonight. Look at his stats defensively real quick. Leading the Bandits in tackles with 7 on the evening, including a sack and 1.5 TFLs. Brandon Stewart to kick off here for Oklahoma. Back deep to return is Fred Bruno and Drew Prohaska.
Please,
Stewart marches off his steps, checks with his men. Now sends him forward. Low kick, squibbing towards Ossie Tapua. Bobbles it at the 21. Now he's just forced to flop on top of it and make sure. Been exchanging of words near the 22-yard line between a couple players. They're going to be separated nicely. Or as nicely as you can separate them right now. St. Patrick's Day weekend. Don't think they're exchanging party information, that's for sure. Scott Jensen out there at quarterback again. He's going to line up under center. Prohaska the deep back. Owusu and Bruno going to go in motion. Sammy Epps, the wide receiver, lined up on the line of scrimmage. Jensen goes under his center fluker. Jet sweep, handoff, Bruno off the right side. Gets some blocks, gets off of one of his blockers, and then goes forward further for a gain to the 23, 24-yard line. And even about 5 yards on the carry brings up second and five for after that Fred Bruno jet sweep. Scott Jensen going to line up under center again. Prohaska the running back. Hand off other side to Bruno this time on a jet sweep. He's going to get enough for a first down there. Gain of about six or seven. Move those chains. Leslie Owusu a little slow to get up for Sioux City. He's getting up and walking fine, though. They're going to give him a breather. Braden Mintz comes in, presumably to play receiver. Showing his versatility once again. As a rushing touchdown on this one, he's played receiver a few times. He's handled kickoffs. And he is the leading tackler for Sioux City. Guy who did not play in last week's preseason game against Minneapolis. Showing why he's a vital part of the defense here today. And offense and special teams. Scott Jensen going to go under center again. First and 10 for about the 18. Delayed handoff there, blown up in the backfield. Look at a miscommunication between Jensen and Prohaska. Great defensive effort there. Looks like Austin Jones was in there. Well, as Smalls. Brings up second and long now for the Bandits after that tackle in the backfield. Middle miscommunication between the quarterback and running back. Jensen going to line up under center again with Prohaska is running back behind him. Bruno and Mintz going to go in motion. Jensen takes the snap, fakes the handoff, bootleg to the right. Heavy pressure, just dumps it down. He was looking for Prohaska. Great pressure there generated by the defensive line for Oklahoma. Third and long here. They're going to say about 14 to go. Third and 13, third and 14 to go for Sioux City here. You want to try to get at least half of it back, and it would set you up in a position where it is, if Amundsen could get a kickoff as well. You only lead by seven if you're Sioux City. Trying to add to that here. A lot of players jump. Jensen's going to get a free play. He's looking for Sammy Epps along the boards, and that one is going to be caught by a fan in the stands. But a free play for Sioux City means that they're going to march off more yards against Oklahoma. Referee is conferring here. We'll get the official ruling. Going to get an illegal defense against Arnell Anderson, the defensive back out of Illinois State. Shotgun formation here for Scott Jensen. Prohaska on his left. Jensen, low snap, rolls to him a little bit. He's going to fire a quick left side to Prohaska. He's got some space, gets the first down inside the five. First and goal for the Bandits. Inside the red zone. The Bandits have four trips to the red zone so far today. All four of them have ended in scores. Trying to Trying to make it 5-for-5 here, and it's first and goal from the 5. As Jensen finds Prohaska on that swing route out of the backfield. Jensen in the shotgun again, sends Bruno and Epps to the line this time. Low snap, gets it, looks right side, swing pass right side to Drew Prohaska, dives into the end zone, up and over a defender. Drew Prohaska turned into Superman himself. That was Scott Jensen's nickname by the day. He just borrowed the moniker. 31-18 now. Sioux City leads, pending the extra point. Big touchdown pitch and catch from Scott Jensen to Drew Prohaska. Jensen surpassed 200 career passing touchdowns. Head coach Irv Strobien looks like he is going to get career win number 100 if his offense keeps making plays like that and his defense stiffens up here down the stretch. Snap gets away, picked up by Amundsen. Now Lonstein, and he's knocked away from behind. That's a fumble. It's a live ball. Picked up by Anderson, trying to find some space. Ball knocked away again. It's almost loose. Picked up Lakeith Murray. It was a Lemony Snicket series of unfortunate events for both sides of the field right there. It's going to end in no points being scored for either team. A low snap rolled to Lonstein as him and Amundsen tried to pick it up. It got away into the hands of Anderson. As he was ripped down, it popped up again into the arms of Lakeith Murray. Finally, after that, the play ended. We go back to the touchdown, though. Jumping into the end zone, Drew Prohaska found him on the swing route off the right side, did Scott Jensen. His second touchdown pass of the day. 31-18 now your score. Sioux City leads Oklahoma. Braden Mines to kick off here for the Bandits as we return to live action. Give you an update on that game between Idaho and Carolina. It is still 23-21. Carolina leading. That's at the halftime break now out in Idaho. Tees down. Mines is just waiting to get the ball from the official. Back deep to return for Oklahoma is Rashad Ridley. South Dakota School of Mines product. Mines walks it off. Telling his team to calm down. There's been a couple offsides on the kick for Sioux City today. Mines sends this one high end over end. Ridley waiting for it near the high V logo. He takes it inside his own end zone. Has some space up the middle. He's going to meet Braden Mines at the 16-yard line, though. And Braden Mines laid the boomstick on Ridley. Welcome back for another season, Braden Mines. Doing it all out there on the field for Sioux City. Another tackle for him as well. He's already leading the team today. A bit of a different formation here on defense for Sioux City. Looks like DJ Reese has stepped in on the defensive side of the ball. He'll play nose tackle. Tapua and Groenhagen are on each end. Mines off the field, so Aaron Roundtree, who's lined up at defensive back and defensive lineman today, is now a linebacker. Empty set for Torrance Carr-Young. He takes the snap out belt high, now fires over the middle of the field. Sliding catch made by Zuri Davis back to his feet in a hurry. He's eventually brought down by Carlton Watkins. It's going to be a gain of about 8. Brings up 2nd and 2. Xavier Spann was in there as well. It was a deep shotgun for Torrance Carr-Young. Now he takes a few steps up. Sends his men to the line. Chest high, snap, takes his drop, got a couple men breathing down his neck, fires downfield. Carlton Watkins is back there, tries to make an effort on the ball, but Zuri Davis brings it in. Another touchdown for Oklahoma. Cuts into this lead again. It's back to a one-score game as Torrence Carr-Young finds Zuri Davis on the deep ball. There were two Oklahoma defenders back there. Looked like a two-on-one fast break with Carlton Watkins trying to defend the paint. You can see it there again on the replay. Watkins had to try to pick and choose which one he was going after. Great throw from Torrence Carr-Young. Zuri Davis, the hero of this drive. A couple catches for him. Ends up in 6 points for Oklahoma. They trail by seven now, and they're going for two. Torrence Carr-Young in the shotgun here. 31-24, your score. Carr-Young takes a snap, direct snap. Trying to get it off the right side. Quarterback power, nothing doing there. It remains a 7-point game. A quick answer for Oklahoma. Makes it 31-24, 7-point game. .39 to go in this fourth quarter of play. It's been a game of runs. It started out 6-0 Oklahoma, then 25 unanswered points for the Bandits. And since then, three of the last four scores have belonged to the Flying Aces, which gives us a 31-24 matchup. Extra points and special teams have been hard to come by as well for both these teams. There's been five total field goal attempts between the two squads. None have been able to hit yet. PATs have also been an issue. Five missed PATs so far between the two kickers. And there was a sixth PAT that ended up failing due to a low snap that rolled away. Stewart. Puts the ball on the tee for Oklahoma. Fred Bruno, the lone man back deep to return. It's the hands team up. Other seven players for the Bandits are within about 16 yards of the kicker. Stewart, driven kick, gonna bounce about the 17, rolls to Fred Bruno. He picks it up at the four. Taking his time, staying patient, finds the gap, cuts through a hole. Fred Bruno puts the stiff arm on. He's got one man to beat the kicker. Fred Bruno, he makes a house call and puts the Bandits back on top by double digits. 37-24, pending the extra point. Fred Bruno, show them why they call you the franchise. Sends them back for another touchdown. 37-24, Sioux City leads. That's how quickly a game can change in the National Arena League. Think about the last four plays. We saw a tough catch over the middle by Zuri Davis, a deep ball to Zuri Davis, and then a kick return for touchdown right there by Fred Bruno. Snap is good, hold is down from Launstein. Kick up off the left post, no good for Jared Amundson. Tale of 2 weeks for Amundson. Went six for seven on extra point attempts last week. Or five for six, excuse me. Has not been a day to remember for him today. Got to work out whatever bugs may have formed in the last week. But what a kick return for a touchdown by the franchise, Fred Bruno. We'll see who comes back out here for the Oklahoma Flying Aces offense. Look down to my right. A couple fans in the stands look a little familiar. Standouts for the Bandits in recent years, Dejon Emery and Claude Davis are here as fans today. Not playing for the Bandits this season. Playing a little farther north on I-29 this year, so I've been told. Looks like Lorenzo Brown, the former quarterback for the Bandits, is here as well, as I saw him down there with him. Lorenzo Brown, a legend of the indoor game, longtime Sioux Falls Storm quarterback. Spent some time for the Bandits as well. Mines to kick off. Boots this one end over end. Going towards the back of the end zone. Rashad Ridley will bounce off the boards as he brings it in. Trying to get down that left sideline. Braden Mines is there to meet him. Flag's going to fly on the play as well. That was brought to you by Flanzone. That's a Flanzone penalty flag, excuse me. It's going to be a hold against the Flying Aces. It's going to go against number 6. That's Thomas Bingham, who had a touchdown catch earlier on in this one. It's going to push the Flying Aces back even more. First and 10 from their own 5-yard line is what they're going to call it. First and 10 from their own 5. Torrance Carr-Young in the shotgun. Empty set here. We have not seen Manalo Caldwell since he went out a little shaken up a couple drives ago. Carr-Young, handoff, jet sweep. Rashad Ridley is brought down by Devin Groenhagen and Juan Moore. Gain of a couple on that jet sweep to Ridley. We'll see what they do next. Second and 8 here for Oklahoma. They trail by 13. It's a 37-24 ball game. It's been about a 13-point ball game for most of this second half. Empty set for Carr-Young again. Chest high snap. He's looking left side. Got some pressure up the middle. Just misses Bingham there. Trying to reach out with the right hand. Couldn't bring it in. Third down and 8 now. Crucial third down for Oklahoma. We are under 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter of play. They need to put together a drive quick, fast, and in a hurry. This way this Bandits offense has been able to click lately. I don't want to see it back in the hands of the Sioux City Bandits. Snap, about belt high. Carr-Young steps up, firing deep downfield, looking for Zuri Davis. Sherman Gilbert is there to get the pick at the 8-yard line of the Sioux City Bandits. Could put one of the nails in the coffin of this game. Jump the route, Sherman Gilbert, his first interception is a Sioux City Bandit, the younger brother of Justin Gilbert, making a name for himself for these Sioux City Bandits. 37-24 your score, minute 33 to go in quarter 4. First and 10 from their own 8-yard line for Sioux City. Scott Jensen going back out there at the quarterback position again. First and 10 for the Bandits. They're going power formation here from their own 8-yard line. Scott Jensen at quarterback, Groenhagen the fullback. Hand off Prohaska. He's got a couple blockers in front of him. Gets forward for a few more yards. Going to be second down and about 6. That's going to take us to the 1 minute warning here in quarter number 4. The Bandits lead 37-24. It's the week 1 action in the National Arena League. Thank you for joining me this evening. I've been Braden Butler so far. I will continue to be so throughout hopefully the rest of my life, but I digress. Take a look at the other game in the National Arena League right now. The Carolina Cobras taking on the Idaho Horsemen. The Horsemen trail at home to Carolina, 21-23. Big play there defensively on that last drive for Sherman Gilbert, the younger brother of Justin Gilbert. Pair of brothers playing for this team. That interception gave the Bandits the ball back with a minute to go. 37-24. They'll be second and about five when they return to action here after this media timeout. Staying, it looks like, in that power formation for the Bandits here. Scott Jensen's going to go under his big center, Stephen Fluker. It's a lot of sirloin meat in that offensive line with Fluker at 6'6", Mungro at 6'6", and Roberts at 6'4". Handoff, Mainz up the middle, trying to find some space. Doesn't get a lot of it, but gets a couple, makes it third and short. That clock keeps ticking. Oklahoma not using any of their timeouts. Third and short here for Sioux City. Under 40 seconds to go, now under 35 to go. Whistle is going to blow, so we're going to get a stoppage here. Referee wants to confer. Play clock issue here inside the Tyson Event Center is what they were conferring about. Resets it to 25. Still trying to get it right here. 33 seconds to go in quarter number four. It's third and two. Now the play clock starts rolling. Jensen under center, Groenhag in the fullback, split backfield, Prohaska and Mainz. Good defensive effort up the middle there. Blows that play up in the backfield. That's Smalls again. Brings up fourth and short. Timeout taken by Oklahoma. They want the ball back, potentially. The Bandits were just going to let the clock run out and end this one with Coach Strobien's 100th career win as head coach. You got to assume with the Bandits get a first down here, both teams just let that clock keep running out. 18 seconds to go in this one. They're going to stay in that power formation. Looks like it. Epps the only receiver on the field. Unless you count Mainz, who's lined up at receiver multiple times tonight. Mainz and Prohaska will be the deep backs, split apart. Groenhag in the fullback. Jensen goes under center. Takes the snap, handoff up the middle. Braden Mainz, left side, first down, trucks through a couple more. That gets to the 24-yard line, fresh set of downs. First down for the Bandits. The clock starts rolling. Nobody is going to stop it. That is career win number 100 for head coach Irv Strobien, longtime Bandit as a player and now as a head coach. He's getting a bath. Whether he likes it or not, he's getting a bath from defensive coordinator Marlon Loban. He's going to get a lot of love from his players, from people within the organization. Now even more on him. Juan Moore is there.
100.
He doesn't need a shower tonight. He's got everything he needs. Irv Strobing, his 100th career win as head coach, 37-24 is your final score here in week one of the National Arena League. It's the Iowa Corn Agriculture Appreciation Night as well. Congratulations to Coach Strobing on 100 career wins, and congratulations to Scott Jensen, 200 career touchdown passes. Got a video playing right now on the Jumbotron here inside Tyson Event Center. Members of the staff, members of Irv Strobing's family, some former players, congratulating him on 100 career wins as head coach. 37-24 your final. We got a couple of awards to give out. Now I'm going to give out a special extra one for the first time ever. You'll figure it out pretty soon if you haven't already. We'll start with your team stats for both these teams. Total yardage here. Excuse me, total yardage here for both these teams. 169 yards of total offense for Oklahoma, 102 through the air, 67 on the ground, compared to 133 for Sioux City, 47 through the air, 86 on the ground. 8 penalties for 55 yards compared to 3 penalties for 22 yards. Oklahoma, the more penalized team tonight. Each team had one turnover and interception for each team. Individual stats starting with Oklahoma. Torrence Carr-Young, 8 for 14 with one pick, 108 yards and 3 touchdown passes. He also led the team in rushing with 11 carries for 36 yards and a touchdown on the ground. Zuri Davis, the number one receiver today for Oklahoma, 2 catches for 34 yards and a touchdown, a long of 26. Rashad Ridley had 2 catches for 28 yards and a touchdown. Thomas Bingham had the first score of the game, 1 catch for 14 yards and a touchdown. Look at the Sioux City Bandits offensive staff. Scott Jensen went 8 for 20 for 55 yards, 2 touchdowns and an interception. Fred Bruno had 7 carries as the leading rusher for 39 yards. Drew Prohaska had 11 carries for 32 yards and a touchdown. Mainz had 3 carries, 14 yards and a touchdown. And Scott Jensen had 1 carry, 1 yard, 1 touchdown. Drew Prohaska ended up being the leading receiver, 3 catches for 25 yards and a touchdown, followed by Fred Bruno, 2 catches, 17 yards and a touchdown as well for him. Give you your players of the game, starting on the defensive side of the ball. Braden Mainz is going to be your defensive player of the game today for the Sioux City Bandits. 9 tackles, 1 sack, 1.5 TFLs. Just got to give a shout-out to Sherman Gilbert as well with a pair of tackles and an interception. But Braden Mainz showing his ability all over the field today is your defensive player of the game. 9 tackles, 1 sack, 1.5 tackles for loss. Your offensive player of the game, it's going to be a historic man. Scott Jensen, 8 for 20 with those 2 touchdowns. Officially 201 career touchdown passes for Scott Jensen. The first of those was the important one today with his 2 touchdowns today, getting 2 career touchdowns, 200 a day. He will never forget. He is your offensive player of the game here in the postgame. And for one time only, special edition, we'll give you your coach of the game, Irv Strobing, getting to career win number 100 with the headset on. Congratulations to him. Congratulations to this Sioux City Bandits organization. Coach Strobing, great career as a player and now as a coach for many, many years. He can't talk about the Sioux City Bandits without talking about Coach Strobing, whether as a player or now as a coach. He's synonymous with the team for basically the entirety of the 25 seasons they have played here in Sioux City. That's your coach of the game. First time ever for Irv Strobing. It's going to do it for us here on the National Arena League YouTube page. Thank you for joining us this evening for week one of the National Arena League. Let's give a quick check out to Idaho, where the Horsemen have just taken the lead 27-23 as we wrap up here in Sioux City. Keep it tuned to the National Arena League. Go check out that game out west. Idaho leading 27-23 with 6:47 to go in the third quarter of play. It's going to be a great season in the National Arena League this year. Hope you can join us throughout the way. I'm Braden Butler. Thank you for joining us this evening. Until next time, stay safe, be good people, and we'll see you next week here on the National Arena League YouTube page.
Sioux City